All right, we're going to go back to the questions in just a minute, but now we would like to welcome our friends from the Seneca Park Zoo, Dave. How you doing, Dave?
How you
Thanks
doing?
For coming in again.
Yeah, thank you.
Hey, Dave.
How you doing?
Cool.
I have Mr. Legs.
What is Mr. Legs?
Mr. Legs is a giant African millipede. He is not super giant at the moment because he is a juvenile, so he's a baby. But he will get quite large.
So where would I find a giant millipede like this?
We have millipedes in our area, local, but the giant African millipede comes from the western part of Africa. So
Hence
it'll be in the
name.
Rainforest. Yes, okay. The western part of Africa and the rainforest and located on the forest floor.
So cool.
Sign it at the bottom.
Do they really have 1,000 feet?
They do not actually have 1,000 feet. That's where the name millipede comes from. They say that they have 1,000 feet. They actually have about 200 to 300 feet at full grown. So
200 to 300 feet.
Yeah.
So can you tell us a little bit about their structure? Because it looks like he's got all these little pieces there.
Well, as you can see, they are segmented. We're going to have all of these little segments down his back. That comprises his exoskeleton. So that would be the outside of his body, kind of like a rib cage, kind of on the outside of your body. Okay. And then he also has this head part. So he has a head. This head's going to have two simple eyes on it. He's also going to have some feelers. So those feelers are actually how he moves around and how he interacts with his environment.
Antennas?
Antennas, okay. Yep. And then he also has air holes along the outside of his body so that he can breathe. So those would be like his lung, I guess you would call it.
What do they like to eat?
He's a very special kind of insect. This is very important for the rainforest. He's a detritivore, meaning they eat dead leaves and dead organic matter.
Okay.
So mostly dead and decaying matter. So all of that, we call them the recyclers of the rainforest.
All right. How would, let's say, a male and female talk?
The way they communicate mostly is going to be through smells. So okay. They excrete different pheromones. Other ones will pick up on those scents. They also will use their feelers. I brought actually a couple of them with me today, and when they're in their container, they kind of feel each other with their feelers. So their antenna kind of interact with each other and also with the rest of the world. So that's kind of how they move around.
Nice.
What's the difference between a millipede and a centipede?
Well, the biggest difference, the one that's most evident, is going to be their shape. A millipede's going to be much longer. He's also going to have that exoskeleton on the outside. It's very evident, very shiny. They're going to be rounded instead of flat. And they're also going to be slower moving and eating leaves. Centipedes are insectivores, so they eat other insects. So they'll be very, very quick. They're predaceous, so they're predators, and they will go after other insects. So this guy, as you can see, is not moving very fast.
No, and that being the case, how would this African millipede defend itself?
Well, it doesn't move very quickly, as you can imagine. So much like a turtle or a tortoise, it would have to then protect itself with its exoskeleton. So it'll roll up into a ball.
Okay.
It'll curl right up, and the center of that curl will be its head. So its head's in the middle. Rest of the body goes around the head to make sure that it can stay nice and protected. Because that's the main part there is the head. He's going to want to protect that.
No,
well, go ahead.
I'm sorry. I noticed he hasn't sat still. He's constantly moving.
Yes, and he is going to be always moving. That's a defense mechanism.
Do they sleep?
They will sleep. They will sleep. They'll find a nice, nasty area underneath a log or maybe some dead leaves, and they'll curl up in that defensive position, and they will sleep. Yeah, they'll be there for quite a while, along with other millipedes, so they feel safety in numbers.
Are the legs evenly distributed on each segment of their body?
They certainly are, and that's how you know that it's a millipede, is because each one of these little segments that we see here is, in fact, part of its body, and you're going to have four legs per segment.
Two on each side?
Two on each side. So you can actually count how many legs he has by how many of these little ridges he has.
I don't know if I want to sit there and count ridges, though.
No,
it's going to be a large number.
So is there a way to tell just by their length or size?
Yes. Most of the time, this little guy here, he's going to have about 100 to 150 legs. When they get to full size, they're about 300, almost 400 legs. Some of them, if given the proper amount of diet, they could get up to about a foot long and have almost 800 legs.
Wow.
So they add ridges as they get older.
Yes, they molt, much like a snake. So their old skin kind of falls off, new skin underneath, and with that new skin comes new segments, and with the new segments, more legs.
Okay, that makes sense.
Now, these guys have antenna, and you said that, and they have eyes. Do they have ears? Can they hear sound?
They can hear some sound, but that's not going to be their main go of it. And by hearing, it's mostly vibrations.
Okay.
So it's only going to be no auditory sounds, really. It's going to be just vibrations on the ground.
Thank you. Thanks, Dave, for coming in.
Thanks a lot.
All righty.
Want to know more about this animal and others like it? Go to our website, homeworkhotline.org, and click on videos. And stay right there. We'll be back in a second.